Agent DeNozzo. My sincere apologies for your wait.
It's okay. I dig hanging out in concrete bunkers, especially after 12-hour plane rides in cramped quarters.
Your sarcasm is noted.
So's your shirt. Nice style. What is that, Zegna? Cavalli? Got good taste.
I'm not certain how my apparel applies to your visit.
And I'm not really certain how you can classify my visit as a visit. All right. Just so we understand, this is what I do for a living. I interrogate people all day long, so I know all the tricks of the trade, and nothing that you do is going to intimidate me.
Interrogate? This is an assembly room. There's a place for mutual discussion. You have yet to see our interrogation room, but if you continue with your childish arrogance, I promise that you will.
Son of a bitch. How many times did I tell DeNozzo to leave his smart-ass attitude back in D.C.?
You should have checked his bags.
I thought you said your boy was up for this.
You're the one who threw him to the wolves, Leon. Let him fight his own way.
You call this a fight? He better start showing me something.
Take him over the team, huh? He already has.
Now, Agent DeNozzo, what you need to understand is that I am very aware of who you are. Your achievements and your misjudgments.
Okay, stop right there. If this is about my Twitter page, I just want to clarify. I've had a couple of cocktails, and what can I say? Sometimes I get a little chatty.
Do you know who I am?
You're the director of Mossad. And Ziva's father. Although I'm not sure which one's asking the questions.
Sometimes it is hard to separate. And it appears that you have had difficulty separating your work from your emotions as well. You believed Officer Rifkin was bad.
He killed an American agent.
An accident. Unlike his death, which was intentional. Watts was behind that intent. Retribution for an agent you had never even met. You knew that Officer Rifkin would be at Ziva's apartment. You went there to confront him, to provoke him. And once again, you blurred the lines, Agent DeNozzo, between your professional duty and your personal desires. You wanted Rifkin out of my daughter's life, so you killed him. Isn't that the truth, Agent DeNozzo?
It's like I told you, Director. I went to Officer David's apartment, at which time Officer Rifkin attacked me. It was kill or be killed.
If that were true, my friend, you would be dead.
You wouldn't mind that, would you? You send all your rogue agents to D.C., make it our mess, huh? I guess I shouldn't be surprised about Rifkin, considering you did the same thing with Ari. And he was your son. Speaking of family, what kind of a father would throw an out-of-control assassin at his own daughter? What kind of business are you running here, huh? Everyone just runs around doing whatever the hell they want?
They do as I say.
Rifkin?
Always.
Well, I'll be damned.